Still presented mode, I think, or
Yeah,
not? Yeah.
yeah.
For some reason, I'm not able to change that.
Otherwise, just go ahead and do it like this.
Yeah. So, my name is Martijn Visser, and I'm from CWTS, as Bianca just said. So earlier this year, we launched the open edition of the Leiden ranking based on OpenNLX data. And actually, what we did in the open edition of the Leiden ranking, we confined ourselves to a subset of OpenNLX, and a subset of so-called core publications. So what is actually lacking from the open edition is that we don't benefit from the extensive coverage of OpenILX. So we are now starting up a research line to investigate how best we can integrate that extended coverage of OpenNLX into our open edition of the Leiden ranking. For that, we started doing some explorations, which I will show you some of the outcomes today. So if you read the recent literature on OpenNLX, then there are all these alarming statements, like our results show that the problem of missing institutions occurs in more than 60% of the journal articles in OpenNLX. OpenNLX displays certain integration problems with a lack of information and low completeness rates in specific fields. These are quite disturbing statements. Where did we get the audacity to publish a Leiden ranking, university ranking based on OpenNLX data? That is something that I want to make clear. If we look at in the, for this analysis, I've looked at journal literature only, and I compared what it was in the Web of Science Scopus and OpenNLX for the time period 1996 to 2022. And what we see is that even for the journal literature, there is a large, much larger coverage in OpenNLX than in the established databases. Although what you also can see when you look at the trend is that in recent years, the gap is getting somewhat smaller because of a larger an increase in coverage by Scopus and the Web of Science. What we took a look at the availability of metadata on for different fields of those metadata. So first, we looked at affiliations, because affiliations, of course, are crucial when you publish an open edition of a university ranking. What we did here was we looked at the availability of affiliations for records in OpenAlex, and whether these whether for those records that were also part of Scopus or Web of Science, what is the percentage of those records that that have affiliations available? So in the left three bars, you see that for OpenAlex, there are in all publications, in, well, all the journal publications in OpenAlex, for a little bit over 50%, there are affiliations available. For publications that are part of OpenAlex and also in Scopus, that percentage is almost more than 95%, and over 80% for the Web of Science. If we then limit ourselves to a more only the last 10 years, 2013-2022, then we see already that the availability of affiliations is getting better, improves in OpenAlex, and reaches 60%. But also in Web of Science and Scopus, that that percentage is higher for more recent years. If you then look at only those publications that are covered by either Web of Science and Scopus, we see that the level of the availability of affiliations is comparable. Well, it's lower, but it's competitive with the level of the availability of affiliations in records in Web of Science in Scopus. And this is actually what I was talking about because, well, actually we made use of a more limited set, a core set of publications, so even a smaller set than just the overlap with Web of Science or Scopus. But so this is actually much more similar to the set that we used to calculate our indicators for the open edition of the layer ranking. What we can also observe is that the number of affiliations that is available for the most recent records in OpenAlex is much higher than in the earlier years. So there is, we can observe a substantial improvement in the availability of raw affiliation strings in OpenAlex records. So and so the gap between Scopus and Web of Science and OpenAlex is getting smaller. Okay, so I've a similar analysis I conducted for some other aspects that are also important. Institutions is actually not something that is part of the bibliographic record, but is more part of the is a data provider enrichment. So, but of course, very important also for bibliometric analysis. And what we see here is a similar picture as what we have seen for the affiliations. For overall, OpenAlex is lagging behind substantially, but behind the traditional databases. And when we look at when we limit ourselves only to those publications that are covered both in Web of Science or Scopus and in OpenAlex, then we see that there is the difference is much smaller. So another important aspect concerns references, and what we see here as well is that the number of references for content that is not, well, that is the overall content in OpenAlex is much smaller. The availability of references is much smaller in OpenAlex than in Web of Science and Scopus. But if you look at the overlapping publications, then we see again that the difference between Web of Science and Scopus on the one hand and OpenAlex is much smaller.
1 minute left, Martin.
Yes. Okay, so then another aspect concerns abstracts. As an example, we see more or less the same pattern, although the differences here are much less pronounced than with the affiliations and institutions. If you then look at metadata availability for the unique OpenAlex content, we and just the journals, we can see that some metadata fields are very poorly filled in OpenAlex, and that is maybe because that information is not available, or maybe it's just not indexed. That is something that we need to look at future studies. Now, there are some limitations for this analysis. It only concerns journal literature. We only look at the availability of fields, not at the completeness or the accuracy of fields. And it is also, that is also quite important, it's only based on the comparison between Web of Science and OpenAlex, and Scopus and OpenAlex is only based on a partial overlap based on a DOI match. So there are both on the side of OpenAlex as well as in Scopus and Web of Science, there are many records without DOI, and they have not been matched.
Could you wrap up the presentation, please?
Sorry?
Could you wrap up the presentation,
yeah,
please?
Because... Yeah. So my conclusions. On the one hand, we can see that for overlapping publications, that OpenAlex is sufficient, that the quality, the availability of the metadata in OpenAlex is sufficient to conduct basic bibliometric analysis. But on the other hand, making use of the unique content in OpenAlex is still very challenging because of the poor availability of those metadata. But what we can see is that there are improvements in recent years. Okay, thank you for your attention.
Great, thanks so much for sharing these data and observations.